Okay, guys, tap out 64 here. I know a lot of our members have recently purchased Hummingbird side imaging units, and I've had my unit now for over 4 years, so got some information I'd like to pass on to you guys. You guys that got Lowrance units, sorry, I'm a Hummingbird guy. So anyways, for those of you with Hummingbird, one of the first things you need to do if you haven't already is get a SD card. They're rather inexpensive. I started out with a 1 gig card and it worked just fine. I've since gone to a 4 gig card and I'm not having any problems with the 4 gig card. This is the exact 4 gig card I have in my unit, SanDisk. It's an SDHC card, $13 at Best Buy. But memory is so cheap right now, you can get the same version with an 8 gig, twice the memory, for $15. So you can never have too much memory. I'd rather have too much than too little. You can do hours and hours of recording with an 8 gig. You probably wouldn't even ever fill it up. So if you can spare $15, get the 8 gig. If money's tight, you know, you can get a lesser expensive. Like I said, I did fine with a 1 gig. So anyways, after you get your SD card, the next thing you're going to need is a memory card reader. I have the SanDisk MobileMate. Let's look at this picture here, and you can see simply you just plug your SD card into the reader, which then allows you to plug it into any available USB port on your computer. Most of the readers nowadays also will accept the mini SD card. My 997 does not use the mini card. It uses the regular side SD card, and I'm going to assume that the newer units do as well. So anyways, this reader, they sell them at Best Buy. I just couldn't find it on their website, but it's $10-$11, you know, at Amazon, so you should be able to get it for $10-$11, and you probably could get one even cheaper. I've seen them for $5. So you want to get yourself an SD card and then some type of memory card reader, so you might have to spend $20-$25. So after you have that, if you haven't done so already, you need to go to Hummingbird's website. And that's hummingbird.com. When you get to their website, at the top, third item over is support. And then you're going to click on product registration. Once you get to this screen, you're going to want to sign up and create an account. This is free, and all you needed to give them is your email address. I hadn't been to the website in quite some time, and for whatever reason, it didn't like my password anymore. So I have to use a temporary password that they gave me. So let me put that in. And let's log in. All right, now we're in. And you can see now that because I am registered, it tells me my model number, 997C. It gives the serial number and my purchase date of January 22nd, 2008. This is where you're going to go to get software updates a year or 6 months or whenever the next update comes out. So this is an important site to remember. And for me with a 997, I would get my software updates by clicking on 997CSI combo. And it tells me at the top that the latest version is 5.840, which I just downloaded the other day. So I've already got that on there, so I do not need to download it. It gives you some instructions on how to download it as well. The bottom two menus I'm not even going to talk about, but the top selection, Hummingbird PC, you definitely want to download Hummingbird PC on your computer, and this is where you get it. And once again, it tells you it's version 4.2.0 from December of 2011 and gives you instructions on how to download it. This is a must-have. And I've already got it on my computer. So let's go ahead and we'll go ahead and look at Hummingbird PC since I'm talking about it. So I'm going to go ahead and launch Hummingbird PC. And here we are. I've already downloaded three times. So when you see these three lines here, those are three files, three times that I've uploaded from my SD card to my computer. Now I'm not going to talk a whole lot about the unit, but obviously you have to have snapshot on your unit. And what you're going to do is transfer all your waypoints to your SD card. And on my 997, what I do is once I transfer everything to my SD card, I will pull the SD card out, and then I will delete all waypoints on my unit. Because what I have found is if I don't delete them, they seem to stay on the unit as if the unit has some memory in it. But as long as I have them on my SD card, I'm good. I can delete them on the unit. So anyways, you now take this SD card, you're going to plug it into your computer using your little adapter. And then you see the SD icon here, you're going to click on the blue arrow, which will download from your SD card to your computer. And what you're going to get is something like this. It's going to show you all your waypoints. Now, I happen to have over 500 on my unit. So anyways, so once you get to this point, when you're out there fishing, it's easy to add 20 waypoints, 30 waypoints. So you're going to have a ton of waypoints on your computer, and you're going to want to go through them. The quickest way I found to find your most recent waypoints is to click on your date twice. And what that'll do is it'll put your most recent waypoints at the top. Now on my unit, and I'm still working on changing this default setting, is when I make a waypoint, it saves it with the camera icon, which is kind of annoying and I don't like. But anyways, I'll change that later. One of the first things you can do is click on the name that it gives your waypoint. And you can name it anything you want. I like to name it, maybe give it a B for bugs or WB for Western Branch. BM for Burnt Mills, NWR, Northwest River, whatever you want. And you can give it a number. You don't have to give it a number. But name it what you want and try to keep it short, because when you get on the lake fishing, whatever you name it's going to show up on your screen, and you just don't need all that clutter on your screen. So I'm just going to name it Western Branch 1. Now the next thing you get to do is select your icon with the drop-down menu. And with this latest software, there's, I don't know how many, 20, 30, 40 different icons. The most common ones seem to be at the top. A lot of guys like to use the blue dot. You could use a fish symbol if you just happen to spot a school of fish. Most common, of course, though, would be a tree icon. Got a couple different tree icons. Looks like we got one that's kind of laying down there. And then there's another tree icon. So anyways, personal preference, whichever icon you want. Now, what you're also going to want to do is delete any of these waypoints that you don't want to save, because you're not always going to want to save every single waypoint you make when you're out fishing. And deleting one is as simple as right-clicking and delete. Just simply delete it, and it's gone. These waypoints I just made while I was in the garage, so I'm going to go ahead and delete them because I don't want them. But anyways, I'll do the rest later. So this is great. So once you're done and you have everything you need, you're going to want to upload it back to your SD card simply by clicking the green arrow. I'll go ahead and let me delete these last two because they're junk. Oops. All right, this is junk. I'm playing around. Delete. Okay. So when you go to upload it back, it's going to ask you, please choose how to update navigation data on this device. Update. And I'm just going to say replace. And it's going to ask you again. You say yes. So now it's overwritten whatever was on that SD card. So I'm done. But now, here's another neat little feature that I like. And what you can do is you can click on the icon to sort them by icons. I happen to have the ramp for Western Branch on here. And this is why you're going to want to download Google Earth on your computer if you, excuse me, don't already have Google Earth. So that I can right-click and say View in Google Earth. And here we're going to open up Google Earth, and it's going to take me to the ramp at Western Branch, which is in Suffolk, Virginia. So here we go. And there you can see we're at the ramp at Western Branch. Now, I'll point out one gripe that a lot of guys have had about the Hummingbird's GPS unit, is they claim it's not nearly as accurate as it needs to be. And, for example, my boat was actually right here, right next to the ramp when I made this waypoint. So the back of my boat was probably right here. So you can see either way, and that's where my GPS puck is. So from where the actual icon is to where the back of my boat is might be 10, 15 feet. You know, it's not exact. I don't think you're going to get exact. You know, guys want 2-3 feet. But unless you're in the military, you're not going to see that type technology. Maybe we will in the future. But as of right now, generally speaking, when I save a waypoint, sometimes it gets me right on it, and sometimes it's 10 to 20 feet away. But that's why when I use my GPS features to navigate to that waypoint, and when I get close, I just throw a marker buoy out, And then I switch to down imaging, and I use my down imaging to find the exact structure. But it's not going to get you, you know, right on it every single time. But it'll get you close. So, anyways, that's just something the guys tend to complain about. But there you can see, once again, the ramp at Western Branch. I love this feature because you're going to get out there, and you're going to have days where you save 20, 30, 40 waypoints, and you're going to be trying to, you know, go through them when you get home, and you're not going to remember which one is which. So you use Google Earth and you open it, it'll take you right to, and trust me, if it's a brush pile that you caught 20 nice crappie on, you're going to remember exactly where it was. So anyways, we're going to close that. When I close Google Earth, I always discard the data, no need to save it. So pretty much that's Hummingbird PC, and it's a great little tool to have. So let's get rid of that for now. The next thing I want to show you is a great form, and it's sideimagingsoft.com. And what's great is that it has subforums for all the different Hummingbird units. 997, the 1197, 898, 798. Great subforums for everything out there. So great form. And it's got lots of other subforums. Now, when we scroll towards the bottom, there's another subform called Other Third-Party Software. And I'm going to click on this because I'm going to show you a program that I use for when I want to look at video on my computer. Now, when you get home from fishing, you can look at video on your unit itself, but the screen is so small, and you can only increase the speed by, I think, times two. So if you've got a one-hour video, it's going to at least take you 30 minutes to watch it. And with HumViewer, I can watch a one-hour video on my computer in a matter of minutes. And obviously, the screen of my computer is a lot bigger. My monitor computer is a lot bigger, so much better to do. So what I'm going to do is click on HumViewer. Now you can see there's Yellowfin and there's SiView. These are other programs, and they're all free, and just dedicated guys made them because Hummingbird didn't release a program to view video with, and I don't know, maybe they have since, but I'm using this program and I'm happy with it. So I'm going to click on the top thread, which is HumViewer, and then once it opens up, once again, in the very first part of the thread, it tells you HumViewer software link. And that takes me to another thread, gives you kind of a sample picture. And then it's going to tell me to the download link. Now here's your download link right here. And this is version 67, which is dated February 2010, 2 years ago. It's what I'm running on my unit, and I'm perfectly happy with it. But like I said, there's other programs out there, so maybe you might want to try one of these other programs. Feel free, you know, let me know how it goes, how it works for you. But this is where I could find HumViewer. So anyways, I've already got HumViewer on my computer, so let me show you what it does for me. So I'm going to open up HumViewer. Here we go. All right, now once again, you're going to want to have Google Earth on your computer to use this feature as well. So what happens when you make a recording, it's going to save that recording, and you're going to put it on your SD card. So when you go File, Open, you're going to have to browse to your SD card. So I go My Computer, and there it is. It's under Removable Disk F, and then you can see I have four folders, and I want to go in the Record folder. In the Record folder, you're going to see it's going to give the recording a number, and there's also going to be a .dat file. And what I want to do is open up the .dat file for that folder. If you went out that day and made five recordings, you're going to have five folders in there. So I'm just going to pick one of these four, and we'll open up 149.dat by double-clicking on it. So now it's loading that video. Just takes it a few seconds. It'll be loaded here in a second. All right, so now the video's loaded. Now, a couple options I want to change here. Under settings, I want to go unit settings because it defaults to metric. There's probably a way to get it to stay on American, but I'm going to change it to feet and miles per hour. I'm going to save that. It's just going to take a couple seconds. I like to look at the background in blue. For whatever reason, if you don't, you go under Tools and you go Color Model Editor. And up here, you can select blue, red, brown, gray, green, and blue. So anyways, whatever color you want. And I haven't actually even played with these other settings, so I don't even know what they are. So I've got the color I want, and here's what's great. Your speed control, you can set it from 1 to 20. I'm going to set it at 10, because what I'll do is, if you've got a one-hour video or 30-hour video, you're going to have lots of areas where there's just not much to look at. So I'll just go fast, you know, until I see something of interest by hitting the play button. When I see something I want to stop and look at, you know, I'll hit the play button again. I could even hit the backwards button and go backwards. So, now over on the left here, we're looking at down imaging at the same time, and then down below here is my track while I was out on the lake. I can also, if by chance, let's just say I saw a huge tree, and what's great is when you get home and you watch this video, you're going to see things that you did not see while you're out on the lake, because, you know, maybe you took your eyes off it just to look ahead and make sure you're not going to crash into a bridge or somebody else, and there's stuff you're going to miss. But when you're watching it at home, you're going to see a lot of different things. So perhaps I see some structure or drop off or something that I want, you know, to fish. I can just put my cursor right on top of whatever the point of interest is, and then down below here it will give me the GPS coordinates, and I can take those GPS coordinates and manually put them in using Hummingbird PC. Now the challenge here is GPS coordinates are given in a few different ways, and you may have to Google a GPS coordinate converter to give them in the to get them in the method that Hummingbird PC wants. So since I'm talking about it, let's just say I got the GPS coordinates that I want. Once again, I can go back to Hummingbird PC, load Hummingbird PC, look at my latest waypoints, and I can just simply click. Where is it? Let's see here. It's been a while. New waypoint. Just click somewhere and you go new waypoint, and it puts it all the way at the bottom, and you go in, you name it what you want, you give it your icon, but you'll notice that the latitude and longitude coordinates are empty. They're all zeros. So you have to manually put in your GPS coordinates. And what they want here is degrees and then decimals. So you're going to have to convert it to this format. So anyways, simply right-click and then click on New Waypoint, and then you can put it in. So back to Hummingbird PC. So another great feature that I like, it's just a little gimmick, is that you can look at this again with Google Earth by simply going under Tools and click on Show in Google Earth. Although this program's got you got to do a little work here, so I use the default of Boat Track and I click OK. Right now, it doesn't know where to find Google Earth, so you have to tell it. And every time you launch the program, you have to tell it. So where is Google Earth on your computer? On my computer, I can go to my C drive, which is my only drive. I can go to Program Files, Google, and Google Earth, and then I go Client, and then I go, here's my Google Earth executable. I click on that. It now knows where to find Google Earth. So here we go. And I don't remember where this track was, but we're going to find out. And it looks like it was at Lake Prince. So for those of you that have fished Lake Prince in Suffolk, this shows me where my track was, where I came along. It's just kind of a neat way to remind yourself, you know, where you did the recording. So great, great little feature there with Google Earth. So we close Google Earth. Once again, I'm discarding the information. So there you have Hum Viewer, which I like to use. Now if we go backwards now to something, the simplest thing that if you haven't quite figured out how to do, and that would be to pull up snapshots. You know, when you use your unit, you got to enable snapshots by turning it on. At least with my 997, it's the last selection for your menu on the far right. So once snapshots on and you save snapshots, it's going to save them, and once you transfer them to your SD card, once again, if you remember earlier, we had a record folder, but we also have a snapshot folder. And if I open up the snapshot folder, every time you make a snapshot, it also makes a .dat file. I usually delete the .dat files. Earlier, I already had a couple in here. This is at Lake Prince. It's a nice little point that sticks out that's got some structure. Didn't catch a single crappie on it. I guess it just looked too nice. But from here, you would treat this just like you would a picture. You know, if you want to post this at crappie.com, whatever method you're using to post pictures at crappie.com, you'd post here. And then I can scroll and look at the next picture. I was just, once again, in my garage, I scrolled out into the Chesapeake Bay Bridge entrance and created some waypoints out there just to have some testing data. So That's all you need to do to post a snapshot. So, anyways, I hope this answered some questions that you guys have. Feel free to always PM me or post in the Virginia forum, and I'll be more than happy to give you any answers to any questions that I may have. So, anyways, talk to you guys later. So, that's all you need to do to post a snapshot. So, anyways, I hope this answered some questions that you guys have.